Hi, Ben, it's R12A7 back again along with WobbleH1.
Yo.
And we're gonna do something different today. We're gonna discuss of what we saw on Nintendo Direct last night on their YouTube page. It's gonna be fun. This is gonna be awesome. So let's right now get down to business as I kind of wrote on the pieces of paper. So anyway, let's get to fun. First up, we're gonna talk about our thoughts of what we saw for what's coming up. And we're gonna talk about with Super Smash Brothers. So as you know that last night, I saw something awesome that was added to Super Smash Brothers. But I'm still stoked that they actually brought Mewtwo back from the Melee series. So what it means that Mewtwo is gonna be back fighting along in a series, and he's gonna be the fifth Pokemon to join the battle. But he is gonna be back as a downloadable content. He is gonna be downloadable 28th, which is 26 days, the 28th of this month. Now, from each foot, he's gonna be on as DLC for both versions on the Wii U and on the 3DS. But here's this. He is up. Not for grabs, but he is up for a little, just a teeny tiny price. For each person, he'll be worth $3.99. So that's about $4. For both persons, it's $4.99, costing that $5. But here's another thing. For Club Nintendo members who've already purchased and register on the game, they'll be getting a free downloadable code for Mewtwo, and that's gonna be on the 15th of this month. Am I right? Yeah, the 15th. So, Wubble, what's your thought about that one?
Oh boy. Well, I kind of understand that Mewtwo is coming back. Everybody is definitely way too excited for it because mostly in YouTube comments I see, "Bring back Mewtwo! Bring back Mewtwo! Bring back Mewtwo!" I'm like, "Calm down! You got him in Melee, go play him in Melee." But they brought him back. But they just can't calm down about Mewtwo. It's just a Pokemon, it's just a character, it's just a fighter in Smash Bros. But you don't need to make like a big deal, but I never played Mewtwo in Smash before, but it's glad to see him as a download.
Alongside with Mewtwo, of course, it's gonna be an upgrade for new Super Smash for both versions, so they'll be working on, well, they'll be getting a new update. However, in the future, they're gonna be working on new downloadable contents, and they're gonna tweak on a character's balance. Not for one, but for all characters. So, talk about a little bit of deal, because they wanna tweak it up a bit. So that's what they all want, but anyhow, that's they'll be working on in the future. But anyhow, there'll be also be a new downloadable content for your Mii Fighter. So what it is, they are costumes for your Mii Fighter on Super Smash, both for the Wii and the 3DS. But the costumes are gonna be for each series, like there's gonna be one costume from Mega Man, Mega Man X, two from Zelda, two from Xenoblade Chronicles, two animal costumes and one kind of like a teaser thing for your for one teaser for one teaser that says Super Smash on them. It's pretty cool. That would be awesome for your Mii Fighter, so he'll give a gratitude for fighting with the costumes on. Again, however, it says the price, but this time they really went low on price, and that's good. For each costume, for each version, it's gonna cost 75 cents. For both versions, will be $1.15. So that's a little off. Well, not a little off. A little sweet and nifty that we get to see our characters in our own new costumes. A little fun too. Of course, they'll be available this month on the 15th. So look out for that. And finally, there's one before I'm gonna get to a side note. There's also one more that's also for downloadable content, and that is another Smash character will be making his second appearance for Super Smash, and that is Lucas from Earthbound. But as you know, Lucas made his first debut on Super Smash Bros. Brawl for the Wii. He is coming back for his second appearance to help Ness out. Or you fight against Ness. He'll be fighting along with you. But sadly, you gotta have to wait a while, because that won't be released out until June of 2015. But, well, we'll wait for that one.
BRB.
Okay. Actually, it's not one, but two side notes I would like to make, and I forgot about one. One of them, and it's for Super Smash, they are releasing out new amiibo fighters for Super Smash. They'll be coming out with Lucina, Bowser Jr., probably Moth, Ike. Well, eight of them is coming out to stores again. So, be on the lookout. And if you got any questions about the new amiibo, check like GameStop, Walmart, Kmart, Target, on the go to the major retailers and ask an associate about the new amiibos and when to pre-order them. Side note number two. So, here's this. Last night I was watching on the part of Super Smash Brothers. Something caught in all of our eyes, and that is of how Nintendo wants to hear your feedback. I went in my mind saying, a new feedback. I never heard of it, or I never thought of it. But how? Here's the way. I will provide you with the link after this gets posted. I'll provide you with the link. Now go to smashbrothers.com. On that main site, go down, you see an orange box says ballot. Go to the ballot. On that ballot. Now here's this. Let's just say you want a different Nintendo character that wants to be in Super Smash. So let's pick either male or female. Then go down to the character, so whoever wants to be in, just type male names, female names. The next one is where the character is from on that game. Next one, they want the reason why you want to have that character into the Smash game. Let's just say I want Simon Belmont from Castlevania. So I'll go to male, name, Simon Belmont, game, Castlevania 2, Simon's Quest, Castlevania 3, Dracula's Curse, NES, on Nintendo Entertainment System. What else? The reason why he wants to be in Smash to make an all 8-bit character duel, or he's my favorite character from Castlevania games. I want him to be in Smash, so on and so forth, probably down the line. And after that, click submit. Now, the one that gets the most submission will be that character to be released on the next Smash Brothers downloadable content. That's cool. The deadline. I'm gonna say the deadline is a few months from now, well, a few months. So it won't be due by October 3rd.
I'm back.
Alright. So the deadline of who you want to be, who your character wants to be in for the next Smash, or the new downloadable content for Smash, the deadline is October 3rd. And this I did tell the folks Rubble of how you want your favorite Nintendo character wants to be in the next downloadable content for Smash.
I chose Ryota Hayami.
What game? Male. He is from.
Wait, guys.
And the reason why?
Because he was originally a trophy in Melee, and I was kind of thinking of somebody I could possibly vote for.
There you go, that's Bubble's example. And I just went my example with Simon Belmont from Castlevania. See, there you go, that's our examples. The deadline of the ballot is October 3rd this year, so there's a lot of time to
Yeah, plenty of time.
Playing time. So while you was away, I was talking about the costumes. Lucas from Earthbound is coming back, and it's on his second appearance from Smash. I went from to 8 new amiibo coming out from the Smash and then the ballot. So what are your thoughts about that one?
Wait, about what?
About Lucas is coming back from the first as downloadable content.
It's great to see him back.
Eight new amiibos coming into stores and the ballot. Well, of course, I'll provide a ballot link on no, the I'll provide a link on the description once the video gets posted. What's next? Oh, yeah. Nintendo's gonna release out on a new game called Amiibo Tap, Nintendo's Greatest Bits. What it is is a new game that your amiibo will be, let's just say, picking the games from the NES and the SNES, and you get to play the title game. Pretty cool. Yeah. Your amiibos, if you want to collect them all, they're tapping on the side of your Wii U pad. Well, let's just say you pick Mario, you'll get with Super Mario Brothers, NES, or Super Mario World, Super Nintendo. And there are scenes you can play right through the game. Pretty cool. So it'll make you feel like you're playing the game again. So Amiibo Tap will be leased out spring of this year, but we don't know when. So we'll probably get another update on the next, and then on the next, well, on their next Nintendo Direct YouTube page on the next episode, which I'm looking forward to that. So, what's your thought about that one?
I think it's like a pretty good idea to not only get the retro gamers excited, but also for the people that are new to Nintendo or the younger people just tap into Amiibo and see all the games of the past and see if they like it. And if they do, they can buy it on the eShop. But some people might think about they need to collect every single amiibo to get every single game in the thing. Well, that's not the case because it's all randomized because each amiibo unlocks a different game, not the game it was tied to. For example, if I have a Mario amiibo, and I tap it will load up Excitebike. The Mario amiibo doesn't necessarily need to unlock a Mario game though in the amiibo tab. No, but it's all the fun in getting a random game.
That's true. Alright, next one. Nintendo will be turning 30 years old as of October
No,
of this year.
Super Mario Bros. Was turning 30.
Oh yeah, Super Mario Bros. There. But it was actually on the Nintendo NES first release on what? The American first was in 85? What's the 84?
Hang on. Nineteen
85, so I knew. Hang on a sec. I do got a piece of paper somewhere. No, I got my binder too, so let me double check. So I will put them all down in. Oh wow. Yeah, a second, folks. I'm still going through these. Anyhow, I want a piece of paper there. Ah, there it is. It was leased out October 18th, 1985, for the NES system. So that came in with Super Mario Brothers. So October 18th will be 30th anniversary. And Nintendo is gonna release out the. No, they're gonna release on 30 years by two, no, now I lost for words. Well, actually, Nintendo is releasing their great games 30 years in the past, so our contribution to them is that's what we're gonna do. A Nintendo tribute. We're gonna do a Nintendo 30th anniversary special. And we're gonna play different games from each Nintendo's version.
But wait, Nintendo's 125.
125?
Yeah.
Huh.
Super Mario Bros. Is 30 years old.
Oh yeah.
Nintendo's 125.
Wow.
I know.
Okay, we'll play what, Super Mario Brothers? Actually, they should be releasing out the next Super Mario All-Stars for the Wii U. Because the last thing they released out in 25 years, they released out Super Mario All-Stars 25th anniversary. And that's the same Super Mario All-Stars from the Super Nintendo. I probably doubt they're gonna release that for the Wii U or put every Mario game on the. No, actually, they did that on a Virtual Console. But yeah, the Super Mario Bros. Game is turning 30 years old. I'm sorry about all that. Screw that. My mouth is all excited by from you and there. Okay, next, Mario Maker. There we go. Mario Maker is the next game to be released out on the Wii U. It says this is for a game you can make your own Super Mario course from four series: Super Mario Brothers, Super Mario Brothers 3, Super Mario World, and the new Super Mario Brothers U. That's about four Mario versions. Whereas you build your own course, Then after that, you could play. You could edit, you could delete. It's just like Mario Paint. When they released Mario Paint for the Super Nintendo, it's like a little animation. You could draw. Maybe the best thing, you could play the fly game, which it was amazing for what Nintendo did back in the past. But right now they're gonna make, they are still going through the game's developments of bringing the stuff like pipes, blocks, Koopas, Goombas, Piranha Plants, and even the retro Bowser from 1980s, Super Mario Brothers. It's gonna be fun though. And what's the best thing of them is that you can upload your course internationally. Which is you can upload them around the world. Which is gonna be fun. With different players from each country playing your course. It's gonna be cool though. But of course, Mario Maker will be releasing the month before Super Mario Brothers anniversary. They'll be releasing out September of this year. And of course, need to thought about that one, Robo.
I would really love to get my hands on Mario Maker because there are plenty of games where you can create your levels like Blastworks and Blastworks for Wii and Crap Mechanic Master for the DS. And I don't know any other, I don't think I know any other games where you can make your own levels. But it's nice to have another game where you can make your own levels, make your own puzzles, stuff like that. And it's gonna be, and not only is it gonna be a lot of fun, but it's gonna be a lot of fun seeing what other people came up, and you might get inspired by that and make your own level based on other, your friends and other levels on Miiverse.
What's next? Oh yeah, they'll be also coming out on the Wii U, releasing of Yoshi's Woolly World. It's a combined mix of Super Mario, Yoshi's Island, Super Mario World 2, and Kirby's Epic Yarn, and put it Yoshi's Woolly World. You place Yoshi as a Woolly Yarn, and then go through different courses, and that's without Baby Mario this time. What's sweet about that, they add a new mode called Mellow Mode. And what it is that would say if you get to the point of the game it gets hard, you can switch from classic mode to Mellow Mode. And to make the game a bit easy for you. So you can go through the levels like there's nothing. Pretty cool. Also, like, what can I saw last night was pretty awesome. They're right now making the amiibo that looks like a yarn. Of course, you can play as Yoshi, and there's a green Yoshi, a pink Yoshi, and a blue Yoshi, and different amiibos. That's gonna be awesome. Of course, he is gonna be really the game is gonna be released out this fall of 2015, which is gonna be awesome. Your thoughts of it? Oh, maybe not. Next one, Splatoon. Of course, they're gonna be releasing out Splatoon for the Wii U. It's just like paintball. We'll be actually playing. That's a new one. Playing with paint. This is what happens when my tongue gets twisted. But what it is like paintball with real paint. You splatter around. You get to be in teams. You could do single player. You could co-op. And even there is multiplayer, which you can actually join the battle and fight another team with your friend, or fight with your friends, and win the team's glory. And yeah, that's gonna be fun. And also, they are releasing out the amiibos for Splatoon. About a male and a female. And that game is also going to be released out May 29th. Next up, Virtual Console. Virtual Console just released out two new to be added with the NES, the SNES, and the Game Boy Advance. And that's the N64 and the DS. And the games are also released out to the Nintendo eShop, which is amazing. So that's actually they released now, and the games are also released. And he said that it's after the presentation. So I'm gonna check out after the. No, actually, I gotta leave. When I get back, I'll probably head on to my Wii U and see if it's actually there. If it is, then I'll probably check out what games they got for the N64 and the 3DS. New added for the Virtual Console, which is amazing. There was also talking about new indie games that's coming out for the Wii U. Some are gonna be fun. Well, probably be some of them I can actually download and play. And it's also talking about the new games that's coming out for the 3DS. So I'll be saying, look out for the new games coming soon to the any games and the games on the 3DS. And what were your thoughts about that one?
Splatoon sounds like a really awesome idea. I would really love to get my hands on that.
Virtual consoles, the 3DS and the Nintendo 64.
I really need to get my hands on that.
In that video, they was on about the configuration of the N64 controller to the Wii U. So I thought that was now I thought it was nifty. It was really nifty. It's really awesome that you can configure the controllers to make it more usable to play. And on the 3DS. It's like a basic 3DS. You got the Wii U pad as a bottom part of the 3DS with stylus. And then your TV will be the top part of the 3DS. I thought that's awesome. That is awesome. And it's sweet too. So it is out now on Nintendo eShop. Finally, let's get on to our favorite game of them all, Mario Kart. The eighth one in the series of releasing out the second DLC next month. Now, on that new downloadable content, the second pack, which contains two cups. Four vehicles and three drivers. The four vehicles, one of them is the Animal Crossing. Two drivers will be two characters from Animal Crossing, the dog and both the male and the female villager, and the third driver will be Dry Bowser. Two cups will be included in the pack, the Bell Cup and the Crossing Cup. And on the Crossing Cup, it would be the Animal Crossing course. Awesome. Because that course will contain of each track, probably if it's like each track or different tracks of different seasons of Animal Crossing, like the seasons in real life, like spring, summer, fall, and winter. Which is awesome. And are you ready for this? From seven different versions of Mario Kart, the eighth will include the first time as a debut, and they introduce the 200 cc faster than 150 cc. So what it is that they introduce on the 200 cc, let's make it bit fast, and you have to be precise on getting the car and the rev up speed and shortcuts. You gotta be precise on those too. Now, what it means that you have to be perfect on getting your car wrapped up in sparks, and if you get like blue spark, it goes a little bit fast, but if you get the orange spark, boom. And that's where you need that orange spark in order to go right through, your opponents. And it's like I said, there is shortcuts on each courses of Mario Kart 8. There's shortcuts you could take. Not shortcuts, but get you into victory. Awesome. That 200 cc will be available the 23rd of this month. That one will be on the Nintendo eShop for free. 3-0 charge. That means on that day, get the what is it? Get the 200 cc, and trust us, it's gonna be really fun, and it's gonna make this boy work so hard again of beating the game again, because I've already beaten it again. But adding the 200 will be working on Mario Kart 8 again. But here's this: when the second DLC goes up, it's gonna be Mario Kart 8 again. It's part of SNR. This one is gonna be fun, wild, 200 cc. Nifty, fun, and eating other players' dust. So, Robert, what's your thought about that?
Well, good thing it's not gonna be mirror mode because mirror mode is a huge nightmare. But with 200 cc, I'm guessing it's not required to beat the game because it's a free download along with the DLC. It's not required to beat the game, just the main courses and 50, 100, 150 cc, and then the nightmare mirror mode. But adding in 200 cc, it's It sounds like it's going to be a pretty good experience of feeling like you're really going fast, but you really need to stay focused at the same time so you won't bump into the walls or you won't fall off the track. So before you go into 200 cc when you get it, I highly suggest you practice the tracks again before you get to 200 cc. So you will kind of get more stability and more control with the controller you're using. As for the DLC packs, I hope we get more info on more courses besides the Animal Crossing course, which looks totally fantastic along with the characters. And it's getting crazy that Dry Bowser came back from Mario Party. Not Mario Party, Mario Kart Wii. Yeah, the DLC pack one is great, and DLC pack number two must be totally awesome as well. I can't wait to get my hands on Mario Kart 8 in and play.
What's gonna be on the courses for the second one? Because I know there's gonna be Animal Crossing. I know that's one.
I guess they might reveal more info later.
I'm hoping that's gonna be more retro Mario Kart courses. Probably another Rainbow World. Because I know in Mario Kart 8 they released two. No, make that three Rainbow World. The new Rainbow World from the Wii U. The Rainbow World from the N64 and the Retro Rainbow World from the first Mario Kart series. So I'm hoping there's gonna be a fourth Rainbow World in the mix. So let me see. The first Rainbow World was the new course next. A lot of twists and turns. Of course, at the end of you. Perfect lining your car up, you could go drifting and go right along the sides, and you can speed fast. That's on the first. The second one they released out, we brought back the Nintendo 64 version of Rainbow World, which is completely, it's pretty cool. But what they did on the first, they actually took it off, was the movable chain chomp. Now on the eighth one, they brought in with the train with Toad throwing coins. You could get the coins. That's nifty. And the ending, go for the jump. Woo! Right to the finish line. That was awesome. Then they brought back Rainbow World, because on the 3DS Mario Kart 7, they brought the original of Rainbow World, but they added a jump shortcut, and then they added on the jump between the bumps on each end, the left and the right, and then to go right for the middle. Woo! You can get some air on that. And they also did the same exact one on the 8th, but with new music to it. And that was awesome. So I would probably highly to wait if I could be right for Rainbow World. I probably doubt the fourth one would be the Wii version. Some of the other ones is I'm seeing like probably a bit of repeat. Could be a Wii, could be the DS, Rainbow World, Zootite.
Thanks.
But you never know what's gonna be on there until the second one leaks out next month. So we're gonna wait until I would probably say May's Nintendo Direct. On the YouTube page, see what they got, and then we'll see what they could do, and they'll give us the info Wednesday second DLC coming out. So we cannot wait for that to come. Yeah, so there we go. That is our what's our thoughts from Nintendo Direct video. Yeah, that'll be our thoughts. Our good thoughts actually, so we cannot wait until the DLC's coming in. We cannot wait to play the game again. We cannot wait until we beat the game again. We cannot wait for more games to come. We cannot wait for more excitement. That's it for the video. I would like to thank RoboWager1 as being a guest.
You're welcome.
I'd like to thank you guys for watching. And of course, we got more videos soon, so take care, have fun. See you all in the next video coming soon to a YouTube TV, computer, mobile phone, and high definition. Know you.
Bye.